In the past of maybe one large console to support all the games. What do you think the advantages and disadvantages of that would be?
I think there's a good and bad side to this. The game industry continues to change and grow because technology never sits still. And the problem with that is the games that all of us remember aren't necessarily playable anymore. And there are a lot of orphans left behind. I think it was great that Sony with the PlayStation 2 created something that was backwards compatible. On the same hand, the other machines, are doing an incredible job of advancing the technology in the same way that the PlayStation is. I don't know if a stable technology is necessarily a desirable goal, because it's a moving target. And right now it's pretty healthy, so I don't necessarily know what that would give us.
Now, a lot of people speculate that, with electronics companies making video game consoles now out of the blue, like Microsoft and a few years back with Sony, that people are just going to keep coming out with new systems, and more and more companies are going to get into it. Obviously, you meet a lot of developers and talk to them, and I know for one, the guys at Sega are really against that. They kind of want to keep it, lesser systems. Do you think that three systems on the market at the same time could hurt the industry, or do you think that it could help?
Well, if you go by history, you'll see that three systems out at once have never succeeded. It's always gotten back to two systems. Now, whether that reflects what's going to happen in the future, it's hard to say. The one thing about everybody getting into the industry, it's very, very difficult to launch a game system. It's very difficult to establish a hardware platform. It's a pretty small list of people or companies, big, huge companies, that have the ability to make a system available to the world. And it has to be available to the world for it to really work. I think what's happening is you'll see things like what I believe Panasonic is doing by offering a version of the GameCube in Japan that's also can play DVDs. I think it's actually, oddly enough, one of the goals of the 3DO system, which was to create a standard but let other companies participate in making the hardware, and maybe that's where it would go. But as it looks right now, I don't think everybody and his brother can jump right in and come out with a game system.
There have been talks of other systems that are actually in the works as we speak, like the Tuxbox, which is run by the guys at Linux. You did mention it's hard for a system to get off the ground. What is the number one thing that is the most important to a system developer if they want to get their system popular?
Software. Technology, we're at a point where technology is a given. It's not about that. It's coming out with software. There's no reason to buy a box unless there's something to play on it. So.
Play them whenever.
at all? Or?
It doesn't bother me personally. I mean, I don't care. It's a video game, you know. And obviously the company is trying to sell its product. So I think other people, a lot of other people might have different opinions. Like parents probably would want their children playing games with, you know, a girl like me skating around or skirt flying out every touch ball.
Now, would you like to see more strong women roles in video games like Tomb Raider?
I think, yeah, I would actually. I think, in my opinion, the girls that are really tough and can really, you know, kick ass, I think those are really cool. And as far as girls playing video games, I have a feeling that's what they would rather play than, you know, a cute girl with their, you know, scantily clad. Not that Laura Croft is totally covered up, but
video games throughout your life?
Probably for 15 years.
Okay.
No, I play a lot when I was little. But I don't like the new games.
No?
No. I only like the original Nintendo and not Super Nintendo. Maybe like Sega Genesis.
So you're a fan of the old school?
Yeah.
Like, do you have a favorite game?
Yeah, Mega Man.
Mega Man?
Mega Man. That's my brother. And I like Punch Out and Excitebike.
So how did you get into the industry?
My brother used to play all the time. So I played with him. And we used to, do you want me to look at the camera?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
And we used to play in the basement. We used to play. I was like the first person to get Super Mario Bros. 3 when it came out because it was the best. I beat all the levels of Mario Brothers when I was like 5. And then when Sega Genesis came out with Sonic the Hedgehog, I played it every day. But when like all the new stuff came out, I just wasn't into it. The controls got too complicated and it was too much for me. So I don't play anymore really.
Is this your first E3 show?
Yes.
Yeah. How do you like it?
It's kind of interesting. I didn't know that this kind of stuff existed.
Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? Guess who's back? mixes them hard like some vodka that'll jumpstart my heart quicker than a shock when I get shocked at the hospital by the doctor when I'm not cooperating, when I'm rocking the table while he's operating. Hey! You waited this long to stop debating, cause I'm back, I'm on the rag and ovulating. I know that you got a job, Miss Cheney, but your husband's heart problem's complicating. So the FCC won't let me be, or let me be me, so let me see. They try to shut me down on MTV, but it feels so empty without me. So come on and dip, bum on your lips, jump back, jiggle a hip and wiggle a bit, and get ready, cause this is about to get heavy. I just settled all my lawsuits. Fuck you, Devin! Now this looks like a job for me, so
okay, hi, I'm Doug Walker, and I'm an executive producer at Dynamic Animation Systems, and we're working on a video game called Objective Force. What it'll be called when it's published, it will be up to the publisher, of course, and we're working with the Xbox technology, and we plan on taking advantage of the Xbox Online capabilities, which we're developing towards. It hasn't been released yet, but it will be, I guess, this summer or early fall. We're really looking forward to that. We think it's going to be great. What's the right word? A great resource, I guess, for the gamer, because he can download new levels on the from the system or play against other people over the internet. And that really, you know, playing against the AI is fun, but playing against other people is really where, you know, the most fun is, and certainly in the minds of a lot of gamers.
Now, how do you see the online that's kind of blossoming out right now with the three major consoles? How do you see that changing the industry?
Well, it's going to go a lot of the way that the PC industry, PC game industry, you know, has been doing online for quite a while. So I think it'll help the industry a lot as far as branching out. On the business side of things, it'll create new revenue streams, which is always good. They're getting more money in the system. Everybody's making more money. Makes it easier to develop new games, and the more money, the more new games that are being developed, the more money that's out there, the more innovative things that people can do. The publishers are willing to take more risk on new things. So, you know, anything that's new, that brings new blood essentially into the gaming world, you know, it's good for all developers.
What would you say to people who say that video games are just for kids and people like ourselves are just wasting our time?
Well, I think that's completely ridiculous. Actually, where I worked before Dynamic Animation Systems, our demographic was, you know, 30 years old and up. We did World War II based war games and strategy games. So I think that's ridiculous.
Yeah.
We certainly aim at an older market, even with Objective Force. It's not, you know, for a 6-year-old. So. And I think Xbox has done a good job of definitely positioning themselves as, you know, not the GameCube. You know, they're not for the 6-year-old. Their demographic is very definitely higher. PS2 certainly spans all demographics. And Nintendo is, of course, dominant in the probably 10 and under demographic. So, and online on all three platforms will definitely help move that demographic up. Because, of course, you know, it's more accessible to adults and older teens to really realize what's going on. The younger player doesn't really, you know, playing against another kid doesn't mean anything to them.
Now, judging by the progress of how you're doing with your Xbox project and the progress of the other two consoles right now, do you see maybe a future in working on the other two consoles as well?
Absolutely. In fact, we've had a lot of interest in people as a follow-on project to port it to the PlayStation 2. With our current code base and graphics engine, it really wouldn't work on GameCube. It would be a vastly different game. Even going to PlayStation 2, the capabilities, especially graphically, are a little bit lower than the Xbox. So, you know, we wouldn't be able to do the kinds of things that we are doing on the Xbox. But the core of the game could remain. Whereas if we took it to the GameCube, it would, you know, be more of a arcade type, you know, shooter as far as driving and shooting and having fun. I mean, it's fun. That fun's what the game business is all about.
So maybe seduced by hate, it never seems to all pan out. Is that what all this teaching is needed to scout?